As demand for electricity is accelerating, and as we shift to renewable sources of energy, like water and wind, that are often far away from where electricity is needed, we must both upgrade and extend our transmission lines. I am pleased to welcome Otto Lynch, Head of Power Line Systems, to explain how software can help.
Thank you, Nicholas. Yes, we are in the midst of what I call the perfect storm. We have an aging grid, most of us more than 60 years old. It wasn't built to last that long, so that's just one of the challenges. The next challenge that we have is just increasing weather events. We're getting more ice, more wind, more extreme temperatures. We also have an increase in demand for electricity. The data centers and electric vehicles and everything else are just going to further increase that demand as we move on. In addition to all of this, we also have the shift from carbon-based power generation to renewable energy. These renewable energy sources usually are not built where the coal plants are being decommissioned. And new transmission lines and/or upgrading existing lines are required to redistribute that electricity to the demand centers. All these factors combined are creating this perfect storm. And as a result, we have to basically rewire America. Permitting is our restraint. As soon as we can get the permits through, we're ready to go. We have a PLS grid, which intertwines with iTwin, and that allows us to have a digital model of the entire grid. We have 640,000 miles of transmission line in the U.S. and about 10 times that amount in distribution. And of course, around the world, there's a lot more as well. Trying to model all of that in an entire digital twin is a monumental task. But once we get that in there, we can use it to basically simulate what's going on in the grid. So we can see if there's going to be a hurricane coming inshore. We can see what structures are going to fail first. We can see that if it's going to get extremely hot, we can see where the wire is going to sag into the ground first. Permitting just takes a long time in the U.S. If you cross any federal land, you have to contact 47 different agencies. One of the things that we can do in PLS is to be able to preliminary design lines. So we can do some routing analysis and then do costing and go ahead and design the structures and preliminary design the line layout. And we can do that with multiple route alternatives. And so that is often used for the permitting application. And so basically, when we finally get the go ahead to build a new line for these renewable energies, it's pretty much out of the can. You can just pretty much finish the design and have it going in a few months. One recent success, the Biden administration announced a final transmission permitting rule. Part of this rule is to significantly improve federal environmental reviews and permitting processes for qualifying onshore electric transmission facilities. It is our hope that this rule leads to faster permitting and transmission lines that will lead to a successful transition to renewable energies in the USA.
Thank you, Otto. Expanding the transmission grid quickly is essential for meeting our clean energy goals.